Since her official debut in 2008, Lady Gaga's career has catapulted into instant stardom. Aside from her popular songs, Lady Gaga is known for outrageous outfits while performing on stage and gracing red carpets. The singer has also given a voice to people who've been bullied for the way they look or their sexuality. While the singer is pretty successful, there are some interesting facts about the singer that you may be unaware of. Here are 10 things you didn't know about Lady Gaga. Number 10, the secret behind her stage name. As most people should already know, her name of course isn't Lady Gaga. Her real name is actually Stefani Joanne Angelina Germanotta, and she changed her stage name in the late 2000s, and for a pretty awesome reason. It turns out that Lady Gaga is a huge fan of the band Queen, with her song Radio Gaga being her favorite and also an inspiration. She wanted a stage name that fit her music style perfectly, and as she has always been inspired by Freddie Mercury and Elton John, Lady Gaga seemed like a perfect fit. Number 9, she was discovered by Akon. While Lady Gaga was performing an alternative burlesque show alongside Lady Starlight, she caught the attention of R&B artist Akon. He was so amazed and impressed with her vocals that in 2007 he decided to sign her to his label Con Live while she was a free agent. Shortly after, Lady Gaga started to take off and getting better offers from different labels, ultimately opting to leave Con Live. Nowadays, Akon likes to joke around when he's asked about working with Gaga by saying that he can retire early thanks to how successful she was. Number 8, she was dropped from her first record label. At the young age of 19 years old, Lady Gaga was living in New York and finally got her big break when she was signed to hip-hop label Def Jam in 2005. But after a short 3 months, the label decided to drop her when she was creating more poppy-sounding songs that just didn't fit what they were looking for. After being dropped, Gaga decided to return back home to her parents, and she found her way back to performing and didn't give up on what she wanted to do with her musical tastes. Which definitely worked out for her. Lady Gaga has said that the music video for her Marry the Night is about the day she was dropped by her first label, Island Def Jam. Number 7, she had the same vocal coach as Christina Aguilera. Before Lady Gaga made it big, she was taking singing lessons at the super young age of 11 with vocal coach Don Lawrence, who also coached Christina Aguilera. Once Gaga's career started to take off in 2008, Christina was not too happy about being compared to a new singer whom she never heard of. Aguilera was quite dismissive of Gaga, at least, early on in the latter's career. Conversely, Gaga mostly laughed it off and ignored the hate. To this day, she is still taking lessons with Don Lawrence and is absolutely thriving. Number 6, her father isn't a fan of her wardrobe choices. When most people think about Lady Gaga, they automatically think of her outrageous outfits and her red carpet style. Some of the artist's outfit choices aren't everyone's cup of tea, including her father. When Joe Germanotta first saw his daughter on stage, despite being proud, he was pretty shocked about what he was seeing. Nowadays, he knows what to expect, and while not the world's biggest fan of his daughter's wardrobe choices, he still supports Gaga in everything that she does. Gaga has always been very close with her family. In her early days as a pop sensation, she spoke openly about her strong but complicated relationship with her father. She even wrote a song, Speechless, that was meant to encourage him to get heart surgery he needed but refused to get. Number 5, she's written songs for other artists. Gaga has had so many huge hits, Poker Face and Bad Romance, among them. But did you know that Gaga has also written tracks for other artists? Most singers, songwriters are known for writing for other artists as well, although not always for huge mainstream artists. Lady Gaga was dropped from her first label in 2005. She started writing songs for artists like Britney Spears, Anna Lambert, and the Pussycat Dolls. A few of the well-known songs that she wrote for these artists are Quicksand for Britney Spears, Fever for Adam Lambert, and Elevator for the Pussycat Dolls. Who knew that someone so talented could write so many popular songs without many people being aware of it? Number 4, she had a minor role on The Sopranos at just 15. Back when Lady Gaga was just a teen, she started auditioning for many roles in New York shows without having much success. However, she scored a minor role as a mischievous classmate in an episode of The Sopranos on HBO in 2001. And you totally couldn't recognize her at all. Since then, Gaga has had major roles in things like American Horror Story, A Star Is Born, and her Netflix documentary titled Gaga, 5'2". Along with being an amazing musician, she has done her fair share of acting, which will hopefully continue in the future. Perhaps it's fitting that a story about a ruthless Italian-American mafia boss grappling with all the horrible things he's done and seeking psychiatric help would be Lady Gaga's first acting role, not necessarily for the psychiatric help part, but for the Italian-American part. Stefani Germanotta is proud of her Italian heritage. Gaga's small uncredited role was in the season 3 episode The Telltale Musidel, airing in April 2001. Number 3, her song Telephone was supposed to be for Britney Spears. One of Lady Gaga's most loved singles is the song Telephone, a collaboration with Beyoncé. Shockingly, the song was not originally intended for her to sing. She actually wrote the song for Britney Spears' album titled Circus, but the latter rejected it. For what it's worth, Telephone would have perfect sense on Circus as it's full on the jittery dancey beats and hypnotic refrains that inhabit Womanizer and If You Seek A Amy. Lady Gaga didn't want her song to go to waste, so she decided to release it herself with Beyoncé. The song was a massive success. The rest, as they say, is history. Telephone gave birth to the eye-popping cinematic Telephone video, and the track peaked at the third spot on the Billboard Hot 100. It currently sits at number 10. Number 2, her first album was the best-selling album worldwide in 2010. When Lady Gaga moved to Los Angeles in 2008 to record her album with Akon's music label, she released her album. The Fame and the album sold over 15 million copies worldwide. The album featured some of her most well-known songs with Just Dance and Poker Face enjoying amazing success. Poker Face became one of the world's best-selling singles in 2009 and spent around 40 weeks on the Billboard Hot 100 charts. Furthermore, she won a Grammy Award for the song that same year. Musically, The Fame is an electropop, synthpop, and dance-pop album that displays influences from 1980s music. Lyrically, it visualizes Gaga's love of fame in general, while also dealing with subjects such as love, sex, money, drugs, and sexual identity. The album was primarily promoted through the Fame Ball Tour and multiple television appearances, and was reissued as a deluxe edition with the Fame Monster on November 18, 2009. And number 1, she once opened for New Kids on the Block. New Kids on the Block enjoyed success in the late 1980s and early 1990s and have sold more than 70 million records worldwide. They won 2 American Music Awards in 1990 for Favorite Pop, Rock Band, Duo, or Group and Favorite Pop Rock Album. The group disbanded in 1994 and publicly reunited in 2008. Shortly after Lady Gaga released her first album, The Fame, she went on tour with New Kids on the Block in 2009 and opened for them on their long-awaited reunion tour. Donnie Wahlberg of the group was actually the one to ask her to tour with them after he saw her performance of Just Dance at a 4th of July bash thrown by Paris Hilton. How crazy is that? Well, after knowing these things, what are your thoughts on Lady Gaga?